Learn how to use the Azure App Configuration service with ASP.NET Core in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. Azure App Configuration can store secrets and settings for you in a central place so that your application doesn't have to store them in source code. In this video, we'll take a look at how you can use Azure App Configuration with an ASP.NET Core application and how you can use feature flags. We'll start by creating an Azure App Configuration in the Azure portal. Let's add a new resource. And I'll search for App Configuration, like this. There it is. Let's create one. Alright. I have to fill in a name. Let's call it Tips and Trick Config. And next, I'll select my existing resource group. And that's it. Let's create it. Here it goes. I'll skip to when it's done. This is the app configuration. Let's add some items. First, we'll go to the feature manager. Here, we can add feature flags. We can use these to show and hide features of our application. I'll add a new one called beta. Okay, by default, it is disabled. And let's add a setting here. And create a new one. I'll call this my text value. And I'll type something here. Okay. We can use this and the feature flag in our application. To connect to app configuration, we need a connection string. This one here. Let's copy that for later. Alright, here we are in Visual Studio. I have already created an ASP.NET Core application that can talk to app configuration. Let's go through it to see what I've done. First, I've added these NuGet packages to talk to app configuration and use feature flags. Next, I've changed this method in program.cs. It will now add the app configuration when it starts up. To do that, it needs to get this connection string. Let's add that. We can do that using the secret manager tool. Here I can paste in the connection string and it is kept out of my source code. What else? Here in startup.cs, I've added this line to be able to work with feature flags. Also, I've added this file, which has the feature flag called beta in it. And I've added the beta controller. This will serve up the index view when the beta feature flag is enabled. And that index view is here, in the beta folder under views. And to work with feature flags in views, I've added this tag helper in the view imports file. And I use that here, in the layout file. Here, in the navigation bar, I've added a new menu item. This will only be visible when the beta feature flag is enabled. Simple, right? And finally, I use the setting that we've added to app configuration in the home index view. Here, I render whatever the value of that setting is. Let's build it to see if it works. And here we go. We see the text of the my text value setting, which is this one, so that's good. And we don't see the beta menu item because the feature flag is disabled by default. Let's change that. Here is the feature, and enable it. Alright, I need to restart the application because the app configuration settings are loaded when the app starts up. In a production scenario, it is best to schedule the restart of your app in a period when you have low traffic. And here we go. This is the beta menu item, and it takes me to the beta page. So app configuration helped me to keep my settings out of source code and provides a central place to manage them. It also enables me to use feature flags, which can be really powerful. Go check it out!